Hey, welcome back to Starship Troopers. Bugs are running, but that's kind of the point from the last mission that we didn't fully win. They already took, all right, well, they took a bunch of shit and we got to redo it.
Not happening until we've cleared this rear area of bugs. Then we'll push up and get those guns firing.
I don't like your attitude. I don't think that's what we ought to be doing.
Sir.
I think we ought to get those massive fucking guns before anything else. And I want to get up to those gun batteries at the front. And these guys kind of proved in that last big fight that I can basically do whatever I want to with a small army of actually exactly 5 Mark II troopers. That's what I had last time. So maybe I can just retake the fucking guns like this. All right, taking out this nest was really easy. I wonder if taking out the nests is, like, really fucking easy. And taking the guns is, like, hard for that specific fucking reason. Fuck it. We're doing what my plan was originally. That seems like the most interesting idea, so that's the one I'm going to stick with. Plasma bugs. Plasma bugs? Holy shit. They put a plasma bu- Well, I guess that would be...
Yes, sir.
That would make this kind of difficult, wouldn't it?
Yes, sir.
But it's not really all that hard to... It's not really all that hard to fucking avoid plasma bugs. They only get one shot. And then I can just turn these guns on the plasma bugs.
Our Wavebreaker battery
ready. Yep, Wavebreaker is ready. Kill this fucking thing so it doesn't shoot at me anymore. Wait a minute. I said I could aim outside of a thing's range. Can I fully fucking aim outside of its range? This is across the whole damn map. No, that one it's not letting me do. All right. Maybe they fixed that shit, or maybe that was genuinely just too fucking far. Let's see if these wave breakers let me do it. All right, this is across the map, but it's slightly less across the map. It's pointing at it, and it's firing at it. Holy shit, yeah. There is a range to how stupid they'll let me be. My primary objective is to clear all the hives. I'm not even trying to clear any of the hives but the ones that are in my way. I cleared that one back over there, and I'm going to clear this one out if I... It's a big fucking hive, so I might have a hard time with it. But I already got the fucking gun batteries. They're probably not going to be all that big a deal, right? That's a thing I hadn't actually tested out before. My army size is big enough if I sent everybody in that the math works out in my favor. I just wonder if the math is exactly what I'm trying to work out. Is it the only thing that matters? Army strength 0.3, hive strength 0. Get the hell in there. Don't die. Come on. Even a little bit of you gets in there, we win. Come on.
Yes, sir.
There we go. All right, that hive is down. I think the Mark IIs might have trouble with the hoppers. Because they're not doing a whole lot of damage to them, it looks like. Ah, shit. The tanker bugs that are coming in. I can't just fucking give these a number. Be nice if I could. They did finally send fucking tankers out this way. There we go. Wavebreaker actually doing what I needed. Good. I'm shocked that they got there as quickly and as effectively as they did. I was not thinking that was going to be... quick. I was thinking that was going to take them for fucking ever. I think maybe the Mark IIs actually do have a disadvantage against the fucking hoppers. That seems a little bit weird. It seems actually very weird. I find it very odd if a trooper has a gun and can't shoot the wings off of a fucking, like, big-ass fly. You know, it didn't occur to me until just now that it might be a bad idea for me to be running around picking up these wave breakers. Because there might be a genuinely good reason for why picking them up is going to cause something to actually happen in the game. So it might be a mission trigger. And I had not been considering that possibility. Now let's go ahead and take this base since I'm standing right here. And I'll summon another one of these motherfuckers and heal all of them up. Anybody that's hurting, which is everybody. God damn. And do the same. Get some more Mark IIs. Since we're like building a bunch of this into this, just all of y'all are group one. Move away from the fucking hole. Let everybody have a chance to shoot the motherfuckers. I got an army strength of 7.4. I really want to try out sending an army in. I got a high strength of 0. I guess move over to there and y'all move in. Oh, great. Roll guards. That's fantastic. God damn it. All right. How about y'all kill this Royal Guard for me? I don't feel like fighting it with rifles. I need the thing dead. Thank you very much. Having the fucking wave breakers actually do shit for me would be pretty fucking sweet. Oh, we got a tank. How about all of y'all back up? I'll let these rocket turrets actually do their fucking job.
Sir, arachnids are disrupting one of our bases.
Oh, they can't. That Royal Guard killed the fucking riflemen have been sitting kind of hanging out for a bit. Let me summon down some Mark IIs. Just because if they're here, I've got the base. So I might as well, right? We lost contact. Yeah, well. Good lord. Y'all can't fight anything up close. That's why Mark IIs are bad. That's the reason that they're not the absolute end-all be-all troops in the game, because they actually don't, they're not perfect troopers, which is kind of what I've been attributing perfection onto them, because I've got them in large groups, which makes everybody attacking them like have a hard time. They got to decide, where should I be shooting, what should I be doing? I get so much fucking war support now. Having the amount of war support that I have does really end up meaning that I can build whatever, however many turrets I want to. It's pretty fucking nice. I'm gonna build a small wall of turrets right here that are just the HMGs. And with those HMG turrets sitting kind of behind this fight, I don't have to worry about things coming up from this direction. That's the most important thing right now, trying to defend this base, since it is a very forward operating base.
A unit under attack.
Trying to build a power plant, get some E-Pulse troopers, have them fucking run and do this. Y'all are just gonna kind of hang out and protect this base for a bit. See, I mean, a lot of stuff's coming this way. I'm wondering about, like, the directions of stuff. Ooh, that's a lair I didn't see before. How about y'all get rid of that? I don't want y'all going over that way. I want y'all to go this direction specifically. I'm not even going to try and... Like, I got up to the battle tier that says I can build those mechs. I don't want the marauders as much as I want more and more turrets. And I can sort of build a defensive structure here and then move the defensive structure up, which is what I've been doing, moving it up this road. And I can just have my people kind of defend this base in its existence, and that's it. Or I could use some of my very limited war support to do anything else, and I don't really fucking want to. All right, they need some fucking help. I'm just gonna send in these fucking E-pulses over here. If I can take this one, I should be able to take that four a little bit easier. The hives being an issue is something that I should not have to deal with, as nearly as badly as I currently am. And I'm not doing a great job. All right. There we go. Now I can just kind of get rid of all these fucking turrets. Have these guys go and take that other base. Okay, maybe not. There we go. Done. All right, I'm going to build a Marauder Bay. And I'm going to take... Ooh, there's more than one. I only had flamethrowers before. Well, fuck it then. I'm going to take a howitzer. That seems like it's fun. So the howitzer and the Gatling gun. Is that what that one is? Gatling gun. Both of them have machine guns. It's, the flamethrower one had machine guns. It was just like when you get up close, it uses its flamethrowers on you. Well, that's perfectly acceptable to me. But if both of them have got their own fucking thing and the Gatling gun just kind of keeps shooting, I don't know which of the three is the most useful. I probably won't be able to figure it out test-wise. I'm not good enough at doing that sort of thing. Even against individual units, that fucking thing, I figured, all right, I'll try Mortar Barrage again. Nope, it's still a piece of shit. It is a piece of shit fucking upgrade. What the hell is the point? God damn it. Hate that thing. These fucking hoppers are pissing me off. It's not because they're in any way actually effective at harassing or damaging my troops, because they are only doing that well, like, on a very rare occasion. The reason they're pissing me off is that they count towards that bug hive population in every single thing, but they're not harassing my troops. They're not trying to come out and attack my people. They're just hanging out right above whatever hole they came out of, which means this thing is not losing its population. I think just as like a tanky sort of solution, I'm going to move all of my, I'm going to move my marauders down here. I want them in front where things are seeing them, freaking out, and attacking them instead of my fucking groups of infantry. That says one. I'm going to send in my fucking army. Just go. Just fucking go. Oh, it shifted down to zero. Come on. Fucking hive population not depleted yet is a bullshit thing right there. I sent my people in and you can't fucking stop me. They are confused and dying. What does that fucking mean for me? I sent my people in and they didn't kill anything? That feels wrong. Get in there before they fucking grow this one. It's going fast. Come on. God damn it. Every single model needs to get in there. And that takes so goddamn long. I'm going to defend the wave breakers with some marauders there. And I guess y'all need to get the hell over there as well. They're giving me a minute countdown on this next attack, which is definitely going to come from out this direction, because that's where all the fancy arrows are. I do have a lot of supply, but I want to use that supply.
Tell us what to
Where'd
do.
You go? There you are. All right, let me get down here, I guess, see if I can't build some fucking turrets up front. I'm gonna set all of these priority to kill the tankers. All of them need to be pissed off at tankers. That's what I fucking need.
Engineers reporting.
And then
tell us what to do.
I think once they're just angry at tankers, they'll attack those, and then I can get all these other troops to properly fucking fight something. Hoppers, I don't really need to worry about too much. They're probably going to come up through that area. This fight might be really tough, but they're bad. In the way they've designed every mission that I've done on this, I just don't see them... I don't see them making good big fights. If they're going to send like a shitload of things at me, then I can set up numbers. But then they send like these waves and that sort of thing. And this sort of fight doesn't feel like the kind that's actually going to really mean anything. The tankers are not really a threat as long as I've got them as the highest priority. So that's good. I think this fight is superfluous. They just wanted to add on like a threatening thing, but the whole mission was kind of threatening. They let me do it the way I wanted to do it, so this is another fun mission. Well, that's a problem. All these hoppers, and hoppers can't attack anybody that's in a big fucking mech, and they can't attack the wave breakers. So I've got these fucking hoppers just hovering around these two sets of turrets. Mortars, turrets, whatever. But they can't do anything. They're not actually a threat. Yeah, and those waves are not going to end until all these fucking hoppers are dead. I think I beat the mission. They got nothing coming in from anywhere anymore. And it's really just the two waves that are over here are 4 or 5 hoppers. Yeah. Perimeter secure. And again, retreating is not okay. They don't eat people as their main fucking source of food. If they did, there would never have been a reason for them to fight us across the cosmos. That's not how they survive. Why do you think they're gonna rot out in a desert when that's the kind of place they normally live? I don't know. Hope you enjoyed this episode. Hope you come back for the next one. I'll see y'all later. Bye.